copies of film? Yes. Delete memory of film from mankind's consciousness? Yes.
Oh, hi there!
It's October 27th, and you know what that means. It's the start of the NBA basketball season! Now, I know that might not mean a whole lot to many of my contemporaries, but to me, it's something that's been close to me since my childhood. I remember watching the Sacramento Kings growing up. Back then, they had Jason Williams, Chris Webber, Peja Stojakovic. They were dubbed the greatest show on court. They even almost made it to the NBA championships before falling to the LA Lakers in 7 games. It was the most exciting series I had ever watched, even to this day. And from then on, I knew I was a Kings fan for life. Those were the days. And ever since then, they've been the smelly, flaky ass crust of the NBA! But with each season comes a new opportunity to suck. And to celebrate our failures, I've decided to look back at some basketball video game abominations that are sure to turn your stomach inside out. Let's turn the dial back and look at Pat Riley basketball on the Sega Genesis. Now, Pat Riley is a famed basketball figure, having coached Magic Johnson, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and James Worthy for the Lakers in the 80s. So for an awe-inspiring coach, you should get a mind-blowing game, right? Well, this isn't promising already. Why does he look so stupid here? Anyway, pick a team. I'll go with the Amazon Warriors here. It's 5-on-5, which is kind of cool because it broke away from a lot of the games at the time that were just 2-on-2 or 3-on-3, but the control sucks. It's way too easy to get the ball stolen from you, and you make 1 out of 30 threes you chuck up. Is that the crowd? Now that's pathetic. There are cutscenes where a player goes for a dunk, and the opposition tries to block him, but it's damn difficult to get a feel for. And what the hell are these bars for? Fighting spirit? Oh Lord, no, please, fuck that. Bottom line, figuring out how to play this game properly is harder than 3-day-old stale brownies. As a result, I got my ass handed to me. Look at that shit-eating grin. That's the type of smile that says, I'm gonna go home and kill myself now. Let's try out a Legend of the 80s, Double Dribble for the NES. It was originally made for the arcade before being ported to the NES in 1987, and was one of the first NES games to use cutscenes, even before Ninja Gaiden. Although, comparing Double Dribble's cutscenes to Ninja Gaiden is like comparing an uncooked potato to thyme roasted russet wedges. Is that a Soviet on the title screen? The gameplay is surprisingly accurate and provides a challenge. Half the time your dunks don't even go in, so the game forces you to shoot, and you can't just shoot some errant bullshit either. You have to have a decent look. Only gripe I have is that it's way too easy to steal the ball. All you have to do is get in front of someone and smash the A button. There are a couple peculiar things about this game, like when you enter the third quarter and your player's skin color changes throughout the game. And that I find particularly interesting. Allow me to explain. Many people have fond memories of this game. It came out during a polarizing time in our nation's history, back when Magic Johnson was facing off against Larry Bird for the 1987 NBA championships, and you were forced to either like the Celtics or the Lakers, Boston or LA, black versus white. Maybe the creators were trying to tell us something.
By their own merits, maybe. Black or white, and I'm going to be fair. And some people are going to agree with me, and some people are going to kiss my ass.
Many of these same players who fought against each other so viciously in the 80s and 90s ended up becoming the best of friends, winning gold for the USA in the 1992 Olympics, all of them with the same bonds. Sure, they were unique in their own ways, as we all are, but that never stopped them from becoming lifelong companions. So perhaps Konami was trying to say that we shouldn't be focusing on our differences or dividing each other based on the color of our skin, but instead we should be celebrating the things we have in common as Americans, our insatiable passion for the game of basketball, and our everlasting love for our country. Or maybe the programmers fucked up. Either way, if you want an entertaining two-player game and need a history fix, I'd suggest this one. What else do we have here? Now, I usually don't mess with games that have numbers in them, and we all know this one. Surprisingly, it has its own sequel I wasn't aware of called NBA Hangtime. Here you can create your own players, so you can step out on the court as classic characters like Baphomet and the Lady of Total Recall, and that's always nice. Other than that, it's pretty much the same game, so let's try and find something else. This looks interesting. Let's jam it in and see how it plays.
It starts off pretty simple. Choose the one-on-one option, pick a player, and start shooting.
Mama said, knock you out!
One question, though. How the fuck do I shoot? This control is horrifyingly rigid. I can't even begin to elaborate.
Look out! Gotcha!
Whatever. If I can't dunk the ball, I guess I'll just shoot it from outside. Wait, what? What a dick! He straight up pushed me over and took the ball! Asshole, let's see how you like it. What? How does that make any sense? I get elbowed in the teeth and get nothing. But if I try anything, it's a foul. Bullshit. He gets to shoot, and I get fucked. Now I know why it's called jamming.
Airball!
Oh, that's vomit worthy. Airball! Could you sprinkle some more New York on that accent? She sounds more exaggerated than this
We're
guy.
We're pairing succulent steamed lobster tail or new jumbo lump crab cakes.
Jumbo lump crab cakes!
Ooh-wee.
What a shit-ass catastrophe. Chill? I wish I could fucking chill! God damn it! Enough of this shit.
Remember Space Jam the movie? Of course you do. Everybody does. Turns out there's a Space Jam video game that was made for the PlayStation 1 and Sega Saturn, but it was the only one. I thought with the success of the game, there'd be tons of developers lining up to make a game based on the movie, but sadly, no. Kinda like that sequel we've been waiting 20 years for.
I'm gonna dunk from the foul line.
Didn't MJ already do that?
The other foul line.
Now, I gave you all that exposition and backstory to tell you that I don't have it, but I do have this talking shooting hoops game.
Get your friends together and play ball. You could be Mike or this purple fuck over here. Oh, that bugs the shit out of me. Now, in 1996, I'm pretty sure this was made for 3-year-olds and not 30-year-olds, so I made my own game out of it.
Fuck. Fuck are you looking at?
Slam City was Scottie Pippen for the Sega CD. This game was made during the height of the FMV era, which featured shitty platforms, overpriced consoles, and mostly bad video games.
Don't you love the smell of the submersive morning?
And this is a bad video game.
What you gonna get? Gonna get respect. What you gotta get? Gonna get respect.
You take control of Ace, who plays street ball with random people on the block. What can I say here? Well, a lot of things happen at pure random. Dunks, steals, blocks. The cutscenes are overly cheesy.
$50 for my wrench.
And everything is broken.
You're a ball, Junior!
You can hardly ever get a rebound because the graphics are so chopped up, and Ace looks like he has a shoulder disability when he's trying to drive to the basket. Get away from me, you fucking creep! Oh, great. Another cutscene. No, don't do it. Oh, I almost blew chunks there. That's almost as bad as watching a grown man lactate in his own house.
Well, Section 8 owns the house.
Oh boy, this game sucks. But since it has Scottie Pippen, I'll give it a D for dildo instead of an F for fuckwad.
You and me will play one-on-one. What do you say?
I'll take no for 25, Alex.
We haven't found a really good game yet, but we'll get there. Half the fun is the journey, right? And it can't be too much longer anyway. We're bound to strike gold soon. So, let's see here. So stiff! Why are the controls so fucking stiff? I'd rather be playing with a dead cat with rigor mortis encased in raw and fight my steamroller! I'd rather be playing with Shaq's errant feces! Michael Jordan, Chaos in the Windy City. I never even heard of this game before. Honestly, I never even thought he had a game released. The reason why a lot of publishers didn't want to pick him up is because he was requesting too much money. Now, judging from the front, I'd guess this is an NBA Jam clone, but let's pop it in and find out for real.
And wow, this is completely the opposite. It's a side-scrolling platformer. The concept is ludicrous. Right before Michael and the Bulls get together to practice, a mad doctor named Maximus Cranium kidnaps everyone except Jordan and tells him to turn himself in or else his teammates would become the subject of his experiments. Jordan then rolls through different parts of Chicago to find his 21 teammates. Most of them are hidden behind breakable walls, or you have to find hidden keys to get to them. And to progress through the stages, you have to find color-coded keys to operate different machinery. You also have these little hoops you can dunk on that give you tokens or power-ups. There's a wide array of monsters and villains, and this game isn't bad. I'd go so far as to say the game is good. It's no masterpiece, but it's still playable 20 years later, and that's something. Issue 100 of Nintendo Power had this game listed as number 7 on the worst games of all time list. Why? Did they ever actually play the game? They probably just looked at the cover, read a synopsis, and said, oh yeah, that's number 7. Can't really blame them, but then in the same issue, they had a top 100 Nintendo games ever made list and didn't include Pokemon. Pokemon, one of the best-selling franchises of all time, didn't crack the top 100. So yeah, as is the case with most lists, take it with a grain of salt. Here at Barkley, shut up and jam. But honestly, the whole game is pick Charles Barkley, run, dunk, steal, dunk, and it just loops forever. So I thought, the hell with that, I'm not even gonna play it. But then I caught wind of a sequel that was made for it. It's a freeware game on PC called Barkley Shut Up and Jam Gaiden. I initially thought that was kind of weird, but then I remembered that Gaiden means a tale of, or side story, so maybe that means we'll get to see Barkley in his early days in college or something.
Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. It's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam.
Okay, this game is fucking awesome! You play as Charles Barkley, who in 2041 sent the world into a post-cyberpocalypse with his signature chaos dunk, wiping out 15 million people in the process. The spirit of LeBron James explains to Barkley that a terrorist group is planning the destruction of the Earth using the Ultimate B-Ball, the same ball in Space Jam that held himself, Patrick Ewing, Muggsy Bogues, and Sean Bradley. Barkley then joins forces with LeBron's great-grandson Balthios, his friend the Cyberdwarf, and his son Hoops to counter Michael Jordan and the terrorist menace.
Without spoiling too much more, I want to say, just play it. Take the 7-8 hours out of your day and play this game. You won't regret it. It's full of ridiculous humor, engaging gameplay, and a killer soundtrack. I guarantee you'll love this game if you like weeaboo jokes, basketball, or Japanese RPGs. And if you like all those things like me, then you're probably nerd-jizz yourself like these guys.
Battle Cruiser operational.
You know, I'm the,
Let's finish up on a tad more conventional note with NBA Street. This is a great entry for NBA games. Besides just being able to play basketball, you get to create your own players, do street tricks, and do some cool things like alley-oops and busted rims. Once your trick meter gets full, you can perform a game breaker, which not only gives you 50,000 trick points and a basketball point, but actually takes away a point from the opposing team as well. During the tournament circuit, you get to play against street legends as well as legends of the game, all while always trying to top your own score. It's an entertaining game with many dynamics that helps to keep it fresh whenever you pop it in. As far as NBA games go, I'd say it's a classic, and it's always one of my first recommendations. Playing all those video games made me hungry for some real basketball, so let's head on the court and get some hoops in. Come on. Hey guys, mind if I play with you?
fuck this guy think he is. He looks like the guy from Eastbound and Down.
Eastbound and Down Syndrome.
Apparently you don't know who I am. My name is Doug Butthole. I'm here to obliterate the Blacktop.
I had a dream I could buy my way to heaven. When I awoke, I spit that on a necklace. I told God I'll be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act reckless. The whole much is given, much is tested. Get arrested, yes, until you get the message. Feel the pressure under more scrutiny. And what I do, act more stupidly. bought more jewelry, more Louis V. My mama couldn't get through to me. Oh, drama, people suing me. I'm on TV talking like it's just you and me. I'm just saying how I feel, man. I ain't one of those guys. I guess the money should've changed them.
I'm unstoppable.
Fuck you. Shut up, Bugs!